the actual review of the video. I just wanted to say, between this character and this character, the way their path is going, like, I don't know what type of storyline they're trying to give them, because obviously I can't read into the fucking future. But if they're trying to do the thing that I think they're trying to do, where it's a teacher-student romantic forbidden love relationship type of shit, like, they need to stop. I'm so sorry. You already had that pedophile taking a picture of Zora last episode. We are not doing this again. We didn't know better when we was 12 years old. And we were watching Pretty Little Liars and thought, oh, the relationship between the teacher and the student was so scandalous. Da, 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 da. We are old enough to now understand that that was just pedophilia and power complexes wrapped up in a sexy bow. Like, if you guys can talk about cancel culture, da da da, all the stuff that's happened in 2021, I'm sure you can understand that this storyline cannot happen the way I think you're trying to make it happen. Yeah, so far the teacher's rejected his advances, and that's fine. Let's just keep it to that. Let's keep it stepping. So we start off the episode with the 30-year-olds that bully children as a hobby. It's parent-teacher night, all the students are off being rich and pretty while we get a quick insight into Audrey's life. I initially thought she was just a hostile and friendly bitch, but now I realise that she just has a bad home life. So that explains why in episode 1 she was very overprotective of her friendships, because they provide stability that she doesn't get at home. In this episode we meet her mum. She's a horrible parent. Unreliable, embarrassing, immature. She doesn't show up for the parent teacher conference, tries to talk her way out of supporting her own daughter at the charity function, arrives late in a bitchy mood, gets drunk, embarrasses herself, and cuts her hand on glass because she got called a miss instead of missus. I don't care about her reasoning either. She chose to take it out on her own daughter with her bad behavior. Whether intentional or not, that can be considered emotional abuse. I do not like her. And then Aki, I understand he's just trying to be the mediator, but this is not the time. You're constantly suggesting that the child be the bigger person. That's not something the child should have to do, because their parent is who should be responsible for their relationship. It's mad annoying when people from outside the situation are constantly giving advice when you only want emotional support and reassurance. Oh my gosh. Also, these babes, Luna and Monte, are not Audrey's friends. Not at all. Taking pictures of her mom in that state and laughing. Oh, that is horrible. But continue. You know, I like a little bit of mess. But yeah, Zora's storyline this episode mainly includes Jillian's ex-boyfriend, Obi, wanting to date her. Yikes. Also, I wanted to say, why is she dressed like this for school? I know everyone has their own bougie style or whatever, but what is this? It's giving very much I got dressed in the dark, very much I don't have a mirror at home. But whatever, Jillian's ex Obi, I don't like him. I don't like him at all. Like, do you not have manners? If my boyfriend broke up with me to turn around and immediately date my little sister, I would call the police and file for a restraining order, because clearly you want to see me dead. 7 billion people in this world. Let me repeat that. 7 billion people. And you're choosing my blood relative, my only sibling. That is so gross. You think I believe this whole nice guy act? This behavior is not normal. Normal people do not date their ex's 14-year-old sisters. This show can continue trying to shove this Zoya and Obi relationship down my esophagus, but I will not be rooting for them. Jillian even ended up blessing the whole relationship in the end, but not me. Mm-mm. I wish them the absolute worst. Also, how do you not see the woman when she's taking pictures of you and posting them online? Nah, I'm so sorry. If someone was posting pictures of me online and I didn't know who it was, I would be so paranoid, so hypervigilant of my surroundings. Like, because that is stalking. You're telling me this woman with her dog were just standing there taking photographs and you did not think to twist up your neck any little bit? Like, babe, this picture was taken outside of your home. Why do you not care? Oh my gosh. And then let me use this remainder of my energy to go off on this woman though. Oh my gosh. When she got backlash for posting that picture of Zoya and Obi, all that cancelling should have been a reality check. It should have made her realise that this is insane and she should have parted ways with the account. But no. She chose to have a tantrum. Her big age. The entitlement is insane. I don't even know why Jillian thought it was a good idea to even save that stupid account when it was so close to dying, because now they're verified. And Kate's head is bigger than life itself. This woman has spent what feels like 2-3 weeks attacking the reputation of two black girls. This is not the shade room. Get new targets. Was it not Luna and Monte that cussed you? Jillian has only ever been nice to this woman. This bloody witch. And also with the plot twist at the end where Max is actually being sexually intimate with Aki and Audrey. I wasn't expecting that. But I'm looking forward to see where it goes, you know what I mean? Because I can't really predict that. I've never really seen that in a TV show. But I like the nuance. But yeah, the way Max feels entitled to men needs to definitely be checked. This teacher not wanting you back isn't a reason to now stalk him. You need to dissect that in therapy or something, because that is not okay. But yeah, that's the video. Thanks for listening.